to all nations. Hasten the fulfillment of thy promise of peace that shall have no end. We pray for those who serve your people and guard the public welfare, that by thy blessing they may be enabled to discharge their duties honestly and well. We pray for our comrades, that by thy help they may observe the strictest justice, keep alight the fires of freedom, strive earnestly for the spirit of democracy, and preserve untarnished our loyalty to country and to thee. Finally, O God of mercy, we ask thy blessing and comfort for those comrades who are suffering mental and physical disability. Cheer them and bring them the blessings of health and happiness. Amen.
We will skip our POW ceremony tonight. Our flag is sent backward. Join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Cover. Join me in reciting the preamble.
For God, my country, we associate ourselves together for the fun purposes to uphold and defend the Constitution of the United States of America, to maintain law and order, to foster and perpetuate a 100% Americanism, to preserve the memories and incidents of our associations in the Great Wars, to inculcate the essential obligation to the community, state, and nation, to combat the opportunity of both the classes and the masses, to make right masters right, to promote peace and goodwill on earth, to safeguard and transmit the principles of justice, freedom, and democracy, to consecrate and sanctify our comradeship by our devotion to mutual reform.
Motion carried. Old business, boys and girls state. We had no takers. Due to snow days, school aid was still in session during our scheduled Boys and Girls Day. And the meeting adjourned.
Do I hear a motion to accept the minutes?
So made.
Second. Any discussion?
Just about that excuse in the first place.
He was sick.
Just discussion.
It is to the best of my understanding.
Yeah, well, he gave his answer.
It is my understanding that the first vice is always set.
We could say, what else is new?
So I can't argue that either.
I make a motion we accept the minutes of Brandon.
Already been made and seconded. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. We have 1 minute of correspondence.
From the Elk Plain Grange, sent to the Legion. American Legion Post Day 118. It was a awesome review and appreciated with more than words you can say. The flagpole looks really good outside of the Grange Hall. Thank you very much. Elk Plain Grange, 782.
I was asking to get that in a minute, so we actually completed that. That does it.
Yep.
And it's still here.
And it's still here.
It was not sent fake.
We have been very watchful.
Steve put secret screws in it.
No, we couldn't find
it. Well, I'm just saying, secret screws, nobody, you can't take it out unless you use vice grips.
I'm still disappointed you only put 220 for that son of a bitch.
Didn't put what?
Put 220 up to it. 120 took your attention.
They just make note that the flag doesn't go to half staff about a lot of work.
Okay, moving on to new business. Convention feedback. I'm wearing a blue cap, I lost. Okay. Second bit of new business, changes to service officers. Only accredited service officers can handle claims. I am not accredited, nor do I wish to be. Here's what happens now. We'll talk about Jody's filing a claim. I can help you do your paperwork. I can give you a drive over to the service officer and you can turn it in. That's how it works. This happened, you're gonna love this. This happened because an accredited service officer was 3 days late on turning in a claim, and we're being sued for $35,000.
So what does that have to do with accredited or non-accredited?
How would requiring accredited service officers to be the only ones to process claims have prevented an accredited service officer from failing to file the claim?
Send a person to check to see who's outside.
Is there somebody outside?
Who's waiting? Front or back?
Front.
You see a shadow?
Have we not had a lesson in Legion logic?
You saw a shadow.
Yes, we have.
That's what he said.
I've had
plenty of illogical logic.
An accredited officer missed the filing date by 3 days. We're being sued for $35,000 that the insurance will pay. So all volunteer service officers are shut down. I can help you do your claim. I can't act as your representative.
Yeah.
I can get you to an accredited officer and they can file your claim.
Okay. I searched the premises, found no one.
Okay.
Place is loaded. Some kids skateboarding this
car. Okay. Does it make sense? No. Is it the rule? Yes.
Got it. Okay.
That's the way it works.
What's missing?
Our, the heat took our permanent charger back, we're gonna get it fixed.
Okay.
I got it out of the car, so I can repair it.
So that's the change, so I can still help you get your paperwork together, make sure it's all right, but you have to take it to the accredited office. The office is in American Lake, Seattle, and Spokane. Jody, I'm not driving to Spokane. We could put each other up with each other to Spokane. Somewhere around Ellensburg, the police would be involved.
I would agree.
It'd make a really good story.
By then, it'd be a murder investigation.
Is it murder if they can't find the body?
On our best day, Jody and I are only one incident away from being a headline on CNN. Boys State, Girls State, ROTC revamp. We have to get better at what we're doing.
You do that in your ear.
Yeah.
Huh?
Here we are.
Boys State, Girls State, ROTC revamp. We didn't get anybody from Boys State, Girls State last year. ROTC had problems.
Yep.
We have to change what we're doing. Between now and Saturday, I want you to think about how we can do it better. We are going to do it earlier. And for the people who are involved, we're going to have to report every meeting what we've done. We had problems in one area last year, so we need to fix that. We got to start beating the bushes. It wasn't all our fault. Everybody had problems with Boys State last year because school went away. I don't know what the winter will be like. It's supposed to be better this year. It's a La Nina year. We shouldn't have the snow. We shouldn't have the snow days. But
yeah, we also ended up, what, in two schools, the athletic camps were going on.
Yeah.
Basketball for one, I don't know what the other one was, where the candidate that they wanted to submit was going to the basketball camps.
And the kid from GK that they talked to never made contact?
Well, we had one, two, that was at Spelman Lake that they wanted to send a sophomore. He was so impressive, one thing sophomore, he wouldn't qualify.
He didn't qualify. So we're going to work on that next year. Membership starts tonight. It's a new year. We didn't make our goal for the first time in 5 years.
We got our first 2 in today. Please renew online if possible. It just makes life a lot easier because they've changed how to submit the memberships, and I don't know how to do it. So I have to call down there and find out, or go down there.
You let me know when you're off, and we'll run down and give a jacket.
Off on a weekday or weekend is not any time soon.
Our membership clerk at the department suffered the death of her family at convention. So she's just back to work. She's doing okay. I saw her yesterday. Our resolution failed. We're going to re-put it in next year. Write it a little differently.
The background check one or the other?
We didn't put the background check in the end. And I'm debating whether I'm going to put that in next year or not.
Okay.
The financial one, the background didn't make it in.
The voting one didn't pass.
Okay.
And quite frankly, we got a yes answer a lot. Really? However, the good news is the Legion Act passed. The Legion Act now puts our eligibility January 1st, 1941, to whenever the war on terror stops. So no more would be, are you a Korean War veteran? Are you a Cold War veteran? Everybody qualifies.
Awesome.
In fact, the new application should be out soon. I've seen them. And they don't list any dates.
Is honorable discharged in September?
Since 1941.
Yeah, honorably discharged because there were people who tried to join that either fell between the end of the Vietnam era and Grenada, especially, and the end of Desert Storm, which was 91, and 2001. That was 10 years.
Yeah.
That everybody who served couldn't qualify if you only served during that brief time. I know I had two friends that were more than willing to join the Legion, but weren't qualified.
Was that only honorable, or is it general?
Honorable.
Honorable under and general under honorable condition.
General honorable.
If you run into anybody who is general under less than honorable, you refer them to the Northwest Justice Project and they'll help you get it upgraded. I'm working with a guy now. It's usually not that difficult. So almost everybody that you run into with those two discharges qualifies for the Legion. We're looking at putting 1 million more people into the Legion in the next year.
Friends.
Anybody remember Tom at Silver Creek? Tom's the Atomic War veteran. Tom now qualifies. Because he's a Cold
right.
War.
Yeah.
He's a Cold War veteran.
Yeah, our veteran that was 100 years old passed away last month.
Did he really?
In his sleep.
My second paper, way to go.
So when I want to go silently in the seat, I sit on my phone, and like the passengers in the car screaming bloody fucking murder.
Yeah.
Okay, and the last one, we lost our mailbox, it's my fault. There's no other way to say it. Although, I want to put forth an idea, why do we need a mailbox when Nashville and the department sends all their mail to me? And the whole time we had the mailbox, we never got one piece of mail.
Is there
you talking about it the post office?
I screwed it up.
Is there
it's not due till November.
Yes, it is. And I missed it.
Well, they're supposed to mail me the notice.
They didn't.
Okay.
But we never got one piece of mail in two rotations.
Is it like an ethical
we need that?
Or a conflict of interest or something like that?
Well, since we won't put Frank out of a man,
yeah,
we won't have to worry about changing it.
If you look at the checks Gary has, they mail them to my house.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, the checks are to this, your house? Yeah. That's the only thing I was thinking about, was the bank stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, let's say
bank stuff comes to my house.
Okay.
Well, it does. Right here, it comes right to my house.
The checks come to me, anything from the department comes to me, anything from Nashville comes to me, the IRS comes to me.
That's good.
No, they don't. Well, we haven't had an answer, so they haven't come back yet.
That's probably not the fault of the IRS. Why don't we save $90 a month? Or $90 a year?
Yep.
Six months.
Is it $90 every 6 months?
I think it's $90. I don't know. I don't know if I have a slip here. Is it one on my desk? I think it was $90 a year
We don't need a motion on that, we just make determination.
No, we need a motion.
Do we? Okay, make a motion that we cancel or not renew our federal post office address.
I said second.
Any discussion?
Crickets.
I was waiting for Gary to finish what he was doing.
I can't find what I'm looking for. I got a slip from the post office that I renewed in June of last year. That's the only one I got, that one must be.
Well, the whole year we've had it, we've never gotten one piece of mail.
Well, there's no point in keeping it then, we can get it all the year off.
And I get all the mail at my house. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
You can at least abstain.
He wants it at his house.
Yeah, so the address is his house.
Now, there will be no more notes to Gary's checks, because I don't send checks to the department anymore.
You don't send checks to the department?
No, I don't sign the checks at the department.
I think he likes your notes.
That's all the new business I have, anything from the floor?
Silver Creek meeting.
Silver Creek meeting, oh, Gary Johnson.
If you expect me to read that from here.
Financial report, we didn't.
Oh, yeah.
You didn't have a financial report.
Oh, I didn't. You're right.
Finance.
When you're ready.
I'm ready.
I know.
I was talking to the woman in charge, not you.
Okay, calls come on.
The legacy account went up 2 cents, it's 529.14 now.
I wanted to post it on first.
Oh, 70260.
Jeez.
Stevie, I'm a deep sympathy. God.
And the legacy was, hey, I'm typing, if I only have three fingers.
$529.14.
Thank you.
It's an increase of 2 cents since the last time.
Hey, it's an increase.
And give her a spell check.
We can afford the post office block for that 2 cents increase.
Got it?
Got it.
Sorry.
We're keeping you up.
Yes.
When you go to bed, I should go to sleep. Put the old man on the couch and get some rest.
Is there any other further new business? Old business. All Bethel days is 5th, 5 October. 93.
5 October.
5 October, 93.
We're going to get a good squad this time?
We're getting in early, I can't guarantee anything.
That was a weird setup, I was in the hallways and everything else.
It's at Grand Compassion. They don't have a big area, so I don't know if that means.
We're going to be back at Grand Compassion again?
It says Grand Compassion.
Okay, Bethel Day is when?
5 October.
That doesn't spend all your make this year.
Wait a minute, yeah. Grand Compassion was last year, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm looking at the sheet here. Now, they may be using last year's sheet. I don't know.
Yeah, it's supposed to be Spanaway Lake. We were at Grand Compassion in the gym in the corner last year.
Last year, we were in the hallway.
In the hallway.
With the door there.
Yeah, it must have been 2 years ago.
Yeah. So, that what I spoke in?
2 years ago.
Where is it?
Wouldn't take long to find out.
Okay, the day it's correct is maybe location question.
I'm looking at, I've got the sheet right here.
Okay.
Application sheet, so you can get your sheet to go.
That's safe.
Ben is sending me one.
Are there three sheets to
the
room?
I mean, but that's what we're being rebuilt and everything. I imagine they'll sit there until they get the new building built. issues with that for anybody? We do a flag ceremony.
They want a full.
We fly their flag, the veterans' flag that was donated. They'd like us to refold it properly.
Who is going to do that? That's September 10th?
No, this 10th, this
Saturday.
Saturday.
I tell you, if we want to move it to the 17th.
I can't make it, Chairman.
I'm still out. You can't make it the 17th either.
Okay.
What time?
You can.
Two p.m.
You can make it the 10th.
Two p.m.
They put it for the 23rd, 24th, whatever day it was.
But Charlene and I are out this week. We're working.
And next week.
And she's working the following week.
Yep.
That's a lot of you guys working.
3 weeks straight.
Tim Center.
So you won't be this Saturday?
I told you, I'm in Frank Fall. I can't. I'm working this weekend.
Yeah. I told you. You weren't listening. Dumbass.
Okay, so what do we have for the 10th then?
You have Frank.
The action show.
I'll have to do some shuffling around. So he's pretty good.
Gary, you're out on the Saturday?
I can't.
The Saturday?
I can't make it this Saturday.
You're a maybe.
You're a maybe.
Yeah.
Which, count that as a
next goal. Saturday I could probably make it. This Saturday, you know.
So the play?
We need to have
some people present.
Yeah.
We're going to do a flag folding ceremony. We at least need four people.
No, I can't make Saturday either.
I'm wondering if the weekend for Silver Creek is just a bad idea.
It's not a bad idea, it's just that the date's not a good date for it.
Yeah, yes.
I don't like them. I think they enjoy us coming over there. Mm-hmm. It's just, well, it kind of snuck up on me really quick.
No, we didn't. Why have a meeting because we put out the date.
Can we move it to October?
Sure, we can move it. Just talk to Patricia. September is a very bad time for Heather and I. Well, not for me as much, but with the fair going on.
I'm going to say the fair starts.
End of August.
October.
The 2nd of September, I think, is where it starts.
No, it's like the 30th of August.
Oh, 30th of August?
Yeah.
You want to do
whatever
later
in the
weekend?
No.
Oh,
fair.
It would be smart to set it aside for a month or two until we...
We haven't had one there since...
Maybe go after the fair?
I think January was the last one we had.
We were there.
Oh, yeah, March.
We were there, we'll say March or
April. Yeah, we haven't had
March. March, okay, March.
We had one there in March, but we haven't had one since.
Yeah.
Well, in truth, they don't notice. Okay. I mean, seriously. And things change on their calendars. Patricia just scratches that for me. The monthly calendar, not an issue. Okay.
What about?
And I haven't personally gone by and talked to each of the veterans about it. I was going to do that Thursday, closer to the event than that, so.
What about the weekend, is it the 23rd or is it the 24th?
Of what, August?
Yeah. Because I think that pretty much is like, I know it's really close to when we do the end of the month and stuff like that, but.
It'll be the 10th, 17th, and the 24th. It'll be the Saturday.
24th? Yeah.
Well, she was like, bang. Yes.
I know that's close to when we do our Labor Day meeting as well, but
need four people.
I don't have anything planned for the 24th, I may just...
Good, then now you do.
May just pass out, but yes, I would be down for the 24th.
As far as I know, the 24th is open.
Okay, 24th.
Whoever we have the courage to help, I'll be home for my last trip.
All right, I'll wait tomorrow afternoon, I'm walking my driveway tomorrow.
Okay, so do I need to make a motion on this, or...
I think so.
Okay, I make a motion, we move to Silver Creek.
Well, we're investigating because we don't know if it's available.
What, if it's available there?
Yeah.
It's available.
Okay.
I mean, I've got three rooms to choose from, Patricia will give me the room.
Okay.
Okay? Because if we don't do it, that one time we went out the activity room, it's when that other one was done, that's fine.
Yeah, okay.
So I make a motion to move the Silver Creek meeting to the 24th box. I think we discussed it already.
What are the...
You can't talk to me.
What are the chances we make an informal meeting on the 10th, or an informal visit on the 10th?
Informal visit there on the 10th?
Just a couple of us go through and say hi.
Sure.
Visit the veterans?
Yeah.
Yeah, just where veterans then go around to the 10th, yeah. I recommend though that we don't do it at 2 p.m., we do it at noon.
Yeah.
Like 11:30 when they're getting ready for lunch.
Before they do lunch.
And just visit all around the table.
They haven't seen us in a while.
Yeah, okay, I'll do that, yeah. Like say, do it at 11:30 and we can just sit there and go while they're eating and reintroduce our stuff to ones that we know.
There are new
members there that I do not know their status. Of veteran status, not male and female, I don't know.
I'd hate to have a Saturday free.
Huh?
I'd hate to have a Saturday free.
Well, what do you do with yourself, right?
You have my sympathy here. We'll beat that to death.
Okay, so that was discussion. Are we done discussing?
Just need to call for it.
We'll need a motion.
Oh, yeah, second.
He's already motioned, second.
Yes.
Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carried.
And then anybody can make it Saturday the 10th for about an hour from 11:30 to 12:30. Frank and I will be there and just wander the two dining rooms.
You win?
I'm sorry.
You win?
So is this so that you two can pick out future rooms? Is that what you're doing?
You get a discount.
Then we'll have to hold our meetings here all the time.
I'm going to Oregon.
You gonna live in the tiny homes?
Yeah, I hear they're building tiny homes down there.
35 of them.
I'm in tech with the head of WDBA.
Oh, okay.
So I've got an in.
The tiny homes float better when a Lahar rolls through.
Okay, moving on to old business. I have none. Any from the floor?
Well, the old business you already talked about, the IRS has failed to respond.
Well, let's go home now.
Clay, do you want to nudge them and see if they're good?
I got a note I wrote on here, check on IRS. I was planning to do that.
I mean, I'm a firm believer in no news is good news.
Mm-hmm. Well, except in this case, they were supposed to reinstate it, so if no news means
taxes.
No news.
Yeah.
Well, they accepted that, whatever it is.
They cashed the freaking check. It was what, $400 or something with that fee we had to pay?
Yeah.
So.
We really didn't need that before we do fundraising.
Yeah.
So we need that by October.
I got two fundraising, but I gotta do the...
Yep.
Okay, if there's no further business to the floor?
Good to the order, sir.
I'm sorry, what?
Good to the order.
Good to the order.
For all of us that ride, please be careful, everybody's heard, there's five people that, motorcyclists that were killed this weekend. One of them was a friend of mine. He was the one that caused the accident over on, my opinion. He came, was going too fast into the corner, lost him, took out another bike.
Wow.
He was a Vietnam veteran, and he ran, worked on the helicopter and stuff down at the, museum on the trail. Started the Star chapter in Olympia and stuff, and Chuck Manley. Be aware that some reason the bikes are on the list this year.
Well, the interesting story, going over the convention, too, the Legion Riders, they were by just past Vantage, weren't they?
Yeah.
And the wind blew a bike off the road. And he ended up breaking his collarbone and bruised up and got a ticket from the state patrol for his tires leaving the pavement.
He got a busted collarbone and he
got
a ticket for
the state patrol gave him a ticket for his tires leaving the pavement.
What is the name of the veteran that got killed?
Excuse me?
You gave the name
of the veteran?
Chuck Manley.
Okay, if there's no further business, the chapel offer prayer, then members, please remove your hats.
Our Heavenly Father, we need this fitting time to pay our respects to our departed comrades. As we stand with bowed heads in reverence to them, let us remember the good deeds they accomplished. Let us revere them as good soldiers who fought the good fight in a just cause. Let us silently pray for peace, the peace that passes all understanding. And let us in mind and soul consecrate our hearts and lives to a real America, the land of the free and the home of the brave. The America worth fighting for. As we stand in silence for our departed comrades, may we sincerely say, may their souls rest in peace. Let us also remember the POWs and MIAs still unaccounted for the wars and conflicts. Amen.
We got it. Till we meet again, let us remember our obligation to our country can be fulfilled only through the faithful performance of our duties of citizenship. Let service to our community, state, and nation be ever a main objective of the American Legion and its members. Let us be ever watchful of our honor of our country, our organization, and ourselves, that nothing shall swerve us from the path of justice, freedom, and democracy. Flag of our nation will remain in place. Hand salute. Two. I now declare this meeting closed.